Hi. How are you doing today? It's over, Adriath. You have nowhere to run.
I must say, I have to agree. It does seem my adventure has come to an untimely end. I should have made sure those fools had finished you off myself. Then I would not be in this predicament, one caused by the failures of so many others. I underestimated you. Who would have thought a common sellsword would rise through the ranks to become the general of an army?
I'm the
That's
Dragonborn.
quite an achievement in my book. But credit where credit is due. You have certainly proved yourself a formidable foe. Who exactly are you?
You don't know? Like, your intelligence sucks, bro. I'm the goddamn Dragonborn. Guardian and protector to Rigmor of Bruma.
Ah, yes, Rigmor. And might I say what an excellent job you have done it to ensure her safety. You really must be commended. If I had known what an insufferable thorn in my side she would be, I would have ended it back in Haven. However, I do regret having her flogged. It's one of the things I'm not too proud about myself. It was a mistake. Yes. And if I could go back, I would rectify it in an instant. I would have her hanged instead.
But
The ungrateful, worthless, wretched little brat.
you wanted her. But you wanted her for the sacrifice. Okay. You were part of the whole thing with the sacrifice to bring Malekith into the world as Trinimac? Like. Okay. But she was just a child.
Ah, but you see, that's where the trouble starts. They don't stay children for long, no.
Wow, you
It's
figured out how
best to nip it
aging
in the bud,
works.
as I should have done. Then I wouldn't be standing here at all. You see, unworthy creatures have no right to a future. They need to be erased from this world. Had we won, everything would have been done to make sure Tamriel was cleansed, so a new golden age could dawn. Alas, the new order. Hapless fools. Too busy talking and theorizing instead of getting the job done. Time was wasted. The moment had passed. Who knows how long we will have to wait for another chance?
There won't ever be another chance.
Wrong. There will. If not today, then tomorrow. We will take our rightful place above the multitude of lesser nations. We will bring a new order, a new golden age of prosperity. We shall purge ourselves of the unworthy, the sick, and the weak. Even if we must wait another millennia to achieve our dreams of a true dominion under a living God-King.
You're sick.
And you're weak.
Fair.
Only the strong. The winners write the history books, Guardian of Rigmor. All the others, they get burned.
Well, you lost,
Give it a
so.
few generations, and it would be as if you had never existed at all.
Like, no acknowledgement of the fact that I'm the Dragonborn? Like, okay. Well, it's time to die, Adriath.
Do you think I would let you place your hands on me? If I am to die, then it will be my own to take. Give my regards to Rigmor.
First Roger!
Never turn your back on the Dragonborn. Never turn your damn back. Awesome. Wait. If you kill him, search his body for a letter to his wife. Well, is that gonna be a problem? I don't know if it's gonna update the quest now. Yeah, I don't know about that. I might have to reload that save, and if I'm going to kill him, I'll have to do it without the shout, or I'll let him survive, or I'll let him kill himself. Yep, no, gotta reload it. Alright, that's what I thought.
Give my regards to Rigmor.
Foose!
No, 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 don't run, don't run. Okay, good. It looked like he was still gonna jump off anyway. It looked like he was gonna jump off. If you are reading this, then we have failed and I am dead. Do not grieve for me. I died believing in a new dawn. For a man who will not stand up and be counted for his beliefs can never be a real man. Which is funny that he says man because the Thalmor hate mankind. They hate the human races. Like, it should say mare when you think about it. A mare who will not lay down his life for a cause he believes in, believes is worth fighting for, does not deserve the benefits and freedoms the blood and toil of others brought him. I thought of you today from this wretched northern kingdom. I thought of the sun setting over Somerset Isle and how much I miss my homeland and you. So do not grieve, my love. Think of me just for a moment as the sun sets in the quiet of the evening. Your loving, Tilar Adriath. CEO, Douchebags Incorporated. No, I wanted to throw him off. Feed him to the sharks. Really? Is there like some sort of... Hey, you seeing this? Really? What? What is this? No. No, go. Go down. No, down. Really? That's it? That's all you're gonna get out of that shout? Perfect. Perfect. It's done.
At last, it's finally over.
What will you do now?
I don't know. Can I go home now?
We can all go home. Come on, let's head back.
Are we going to the farmhouse?
Yes, we need to prepare for the journey.
Okay.
Yeah. I like how she doesn't even question it. It's like, oh, journey? Yeah, let's go. Like, we haven't discussed anything else about what we would do, what would happen when it was over. We still need to have the conversation with her about her future, about who she is and her place in the world. I forgot that we hadn't had that talk yet. Oh boy, look who's back.
Fear not.
I was not afraid. But I'm more fearful whenever you say fear not, frankly.
Well met.
Sethri, we have won the war.
News travels fast, Dragonborn. News travels fast.
How have things been while we were gone?
Fine, Dragonborn, just fine. I have a present for you. Several, in fact. You'll find them on the workbench in the stable.
Presents? For me?
Special delivery. I have a present for you too, Rigmor. Come inside. All will be revealed.
Oh, you know.
Really? That's so cute. Let's go.
Anytime he says all will be revealed, I'm always very nervous. Last time he said that, I almost died and Rigmor got kidnapped. Oh, the Khajiit longbow. The longbow arrows. Goldbrand and Azura's Bane. I'm amazed I'm not over-encumbered after all of that. Let me see what Goldbrand does in terms of damage. Yep, alright. We're going with that. We're going with Goldbrand. Granted, I don't think there's any more fighting ahead of us, but... just in case.
Fear not,
all will be revealed. Where is everyone?
All gone home. Byron Dale got called back to the embassy. I said Sigurd could stay here with me. She gasped a little, thanked me for my good nature, and went with the old Khajiit.
Byron has taken Mom home. He's already acquired our old house. Ingol came by, and Angie went with him. Sorella, too. They've gone back to the mountains.
I guess you'll be taking young Rigmor back to Bruma, then.
All of a sudden, I can't help but feel a little redundant.
Hey, I'm right here, okay? I'll wait outside.
She still doesn't know. Thank you for everything, Sethri.
It was my pleasure, Dragonborn. Notice I got her old armor back.
Yes, thief, disciple, mage, and now wheeler and dealer.
All the mages are crawling over that portal site. I had Malasam send it over. It didn't cost me a thing.
And Azura's Bane, the weapons. How did you...
Malasam gathered the broken fragments from the site. He sent them to me. I took them to Azura's shrine. Bob's your uncle. It was that simple.
He is my uncle.
Consider it a little present from the both of us. Goldbrand, I don't think I need to explain. Let's just say someone is a very happy mistress. Byron left you the longbow. I must say, it's bloody good. He also left you this note. Your eyes only.
Oh, I paused right as he blinked. Oh, it didn't get added to my inventory, did it? Oh, there it is.
Dragonborn, this one has been recalled, but Khajiit needed to let you know. Rigmor's family name has been restored by the Emperor Titus Mead II. The Emperor took it upon himself to inform me just before he crushed the enemy in Cyrodiil. This one was going to tell you earlier, but thought it could wait until after the New Order was defeated in Skyrim. Khajiit shall be taking Sigurd to Bruma and help her get established before returning to elsewhere. We would be eternally grateful if you could escort Rigmor to the border with Cyrodiil. It would be safe for her to travel from there, as this one knows you two have a destiny to fulfill in Skyrim. In fact, Khazazid... Who? Khazazid has had a premonition that you will become legendary and save Tamriel many, many times over. Rigmor has become Countess of Bruma. This one thanks you, Dragonborn, for being her guardian. We owe you a great debt of gratitude. What a wonderful day, don't you think? Baren Dar.
He expects me to leave her at the border. I don't think so.
Dragonborn, my mistress wanted me to warn you that taking Rigmor across the border would put her in danger. She's been looking after that girl all her life, and she's never wrong.
What do you mean, Sethri?
Azura isn't sure, but she can feel the ripples in the void. There's some heavy grinding going on. If that old Khajiit wants you to stay behind and send her off alone, there must be a bloody good reason.
I can't. Not now. We're a team.
Well, something ain't right, and I don't just mean dragons coming back. There's more to it. Something way bigger. I mean, that old Khajiit's been staying at the Temple of Mara, right? Ever wonder about that one? Means he's got the ear of the gods. Dinya told me herself.
Dinya?
Yeah. Means and ways, Dragonborn. Means and ways.
By the gods, man.
Exactly my point. Mara's a step away from the old man himself, right? Like I said, there must be a good reason they don't want you anywhere near the border. Any ideas why that is?
The border.
Sorry? What?
Nothing. Wait, now I'm confused. What do you mean? Why did it just say the border? Just because I got, you know, captured crossing the border from Cyrodiil to Skyrim? Nothing. How am I gonna tell her?
Hey, it's not the end, not by a long shot. She's a good kid, and I'm sure you'll cross that bridge when you come to it. Listen, There's an old smuggler's route not far from here. We'll bring you out of the abandoned trading post not far from the final frontier, the actual border crossing. I'm sorry I can't be of more help, Dragonborn. Truly I am.
Yeah, well, I guess I'll just have to figure it out when I get there.
If by perchance you are around this way, and happen to be saving the world all over again, feel free to stop by. Anytime.
Only if you've got some damn clothes on.
Farewell, Dragonborn.
So yeah, I feel like the whole, oh, you can't go that way is, you know, just their way of trying to build up the tension for Rigmor Seardal. It's like, you can't go that way. Mara demands it. My mistress demands it is partially just kind of like a plot point of like, okay, it's building up to what's going to happen in Rigmor Seardal, but I feel like it could easily just be the thing of, you can't leave Skyrim, you're the Dragonborn, you have to stay and defeat Alduin. I feel like if they had painted it as that, that would have also worked out. Hey?
What is it?
You ready?
As ready as I'll ever be.
See, she knows something's wrong, because, even she sounds sad. Well, there's some ways to go before we reach the border.
Hey, we can take the old smuggler's route. Cross over the border at the Pale Pass. It's not that far from here.
Sounds like a plan.
Yeah, Sethry mentioned about it. Save us going all the way back up to Falkreath.
Sethry, huh?
Yeah, I know, right?
Come on, let's take you home.
Okay.
Rigmor of Bruma. Head for the border. Let me just see where it is on the map. Okay. Oh yeah, so we can just walk directly west. That's easy enough. One nice thing is that they did add a different border crossing, and one of the reasons for that was to avoid conflicts with Beyond Skyrim Bruma, to my knowledge. That being said, this is a not an easy one to climb up. I kind of have to do the kind of like little back and forth thing in order to really, really get up this path. Oh, we have a ruined barrow right here. Looks ruined, at least. Yeah, no, there's no way in. Oh, Rigmor? Is she having trouble getting up? A little bit, but okay. No, she's here. She's here. She didn't take the stairs. Apparently, walking on this side where it's just snow makes it a little bit easier to get up, which sometimes steps in Skyrim get a little bit wonky. I've had issues in Skyrim with steps. I've had issues in Oblivion with some of the steps, just like ones that were placed vanilla-wise, except in this case, this does look very steep. Like, this path right here, you can tell it's very, very steep. Alright, I think we made it. Oh god, oh, that rock magically appeared. Oh god, how much further do I need to walk? Oh, that's unnecessary! Okay, that's a little unnecessary. Provide a fast travel point to that then, because there's just nothing here, it's just emptiness. Like, I know they placed the flag so that we can see where we're going, but there's no reason to have to walk across this.
Hey, wait till you see my house in Bruma. You're going to love it. You can live with us.
Oh, boy.
I can't wait to show you the Imperial City.
Oh, do I have bad news for you? Oh, Rigmor, do I have some bad news for you?
We can go hunting together in the Great Forest. You're so going to love it in Cyrodiil.
Yeah, all this is new. They're trying to just guilt trip me now. They're building up to a much more depressing goodbye. What the?
Did you hear that?
I did. Yeah. Yeah, I heard that. It's hard not to hear that. The Greybeard's like, hey, you live in Skyrim, you can't do that. Hey, you're not done here yet. Which that's kind of what I commented on before. It's like, yeah, don't you leave Skyrim. You got stuff to do here. Don't shirk your responsibilities, Dragonborn. Okay, I think this is the same Overlook camp from
the original. Hey, I need to adjust myself, you know?
All right. I gotcha. Take a seat, young Rigmor. Rigmor, we need to talk.
Sure, what is it?
There's something I need to tell you.
Come on, what is it?
I can't go to Bruma. I must stay here in Skyrim.
Hey, if you want me to stay here with you, then I'll stay, okay? I can visit Mom anytime, right? We can go adventuring together. Is that what you're trying to say?
I wish it was that easy.
Dragonborn, what is it?
Sometimes we have no choice but to make decisions that we don't want to make.
Stop teasing. What decisions? What are you talking about? I don't understand.
Rigmor, there's something you need to know about yourself that will change everything.
Dragonborn, you're scaring me. Whatever it is you've got to say, you'd better say it.
I am just teasing her at this point. Morgan of Winterhold was the bastard child of Emperor Titus Mead the First.
By the gods.
No, stay here. The Emperor himself wants you to be Countess of Bruma.
Countess? This is a joke, right?
It's no joke. It's the truth.
Well, I won't go. I'll stay here with you.
Rigmor, now you can finally go home, like you always wanted.
But you're coming with me, right?
I can't. I have to return to Skyrim. I think you already know that.
No! I won't let you. I need you. I can't do this on my own.
You can. You must.
No, I won't do it, Dragonborn. No!
Hey. That's not how we're gonna end this. Look at me, damn it. Rigmor, you owe this to your father. You owe it to yourself.
What shall become of me? I can't live without you now. Not after everything we've been through together.
Your future is in your hands now. Build a life that you want and so deserve.
But you're my bestest friend. What have I done wrong? I didn't mean to make you angry or upset you. Tell me what I've done. I'll make it up to you and put it right. Please, don't send me away. Not now. We're a team.
You've done nothing wrong, but it has to be this way.
Stop it. You're breaking my heart.
I'm sorry.
You'll come back for me, right? When you're done here, say you'll come get me.
Write or message me, and I will be by your side in a heartbeat.
Dragonborn, my heart. It's broken.
Don't cry. You can do this. I know you can.
I'll try, okay? Yeah, right. Well, don't leave it too long.
Oh, I can't walk forward. I tried.
Hi. I love you.
Love you too.
There is
her dragonborn to save her, to never let her go.
Thank you for watching the Rigmor of Bruma reboot here on Skyrim Saturday. While not covered in the previous videos, a major part of this reboot is that the mod author added new lines and scenes with Rigmor that can occur during the first few main quests, including Bleakfall's Barrow, the Golden Claw, the Greybeards, and the Horn of Jürgen Windcaller. If you'd like to see some of these scenes, stay tuned, as I'll be including these in the later part of this video. Having Rigmor interact with you during these scenes fleshes her out more as a follower, and gives her more character and chances to grow your relationship with her. I love mods that add integration for vanilla quests, such as Inigo and Vilya. Now, onto the Rigmor of Bruma reboot. Having played through the original release of the mod a couple times before, there are some notable differences between the two versions. The entire beginning of the mod has been rewritten and redone from the ground up, including when you meet Rigmor, meeting Rose, as well as the quest of going to Fort Black in order to hopefully rescue Rose. Throughout the playthrough, you probably noticed my jokes and comments about wanting Rose to come back. And while it's largely meant as a jest, I think Rose would have been an interesting character to have kept around in the reboot of the mod. Part of Angie's storyline and character could have been imparted onto Rose, removing some of the need for spliced together vanilla NPC lines. Angie should still act as Sorella's adoptive mother, and her house could still be used as a safe house, but having a uniquely voiced character such as Rose would have helped some of the story flow a little bit better. And then at the very end of the mod, you could have Rose accompany Rigmor to Cyrodiil, as they both begin their new lives there. Obviously, I put a little bit of thought into this idea. What can I say? I'm on a little bit of a writing kick right now. While I loved the new introduction quest and how it kicks everything else off, it does lead to what feels like some minor inconsistencies later on in the mod. With Rigmor wanted by the authorities, why risk going to Riften when it means traveling through Imperial-occupied lands in order to meet Barrendar? Why not meet somewhere safer? We see Barrendar freely visit Angie's camp later on as it is. I feel like we didn't have a proper introduction to him, as we would normally meet him at the very start of the mod. It almost felt like some parts of the writing should have been changed based on this new intro, but because they weren't, some moments felt a little bit disjointed. One thing I really appreciated was that the mod did not force the romance aspect on you as much as it did originally. And while it definitely felt a little bit heavy-handed at times, I'm looking at you, Boethia, it felt a bit more natural when you turn it down, and you don't even have to bring it up too much with Rigmor during the later stages of the story. But like I said, Boethia's scene really went hard with trying to force the romance on you. The mod sometimes feels like it's telling you how to feel, rather than giving you the choice of how you feel on your own. Still, Rigmor of Bruma's greatest strength is its writing, and the more personal story and moments that it creates. One thing that I always felt was missing from Skyrim was the emotion. The Dragonborn felt so one note and weren't given that many opportunities to care about others or form connections with others. Rigmor of Bruma gives you a chance to have those more personal connections, with Rigmor, Ingol, Cassius, Sigun. You get the idea. It makes you feel like you're really part of a team and a family, and gives more motivation to some of these quests and adventures. Personal moments like that are what draws me into many games, like Mass Effect, Dragon Age, The Witcher, and so on. Rigmor of Bruma gives me that, something that I think the Elder Scrolls as a whole could really benefit from. Now, let's talk technical. The original release of Rigmor of Bruma has often been described as buggy and unstable, and was often a reason for why many never finished it, or simply uninstalled it halfway through. By and large, the reboot fixes many of the original issues that I ran into, and makes for a much more stable, easier to play experience. Compatibility with other mods has been taken into effect, which is why we see a different path to the Cyrodiil border, or why we see a newer, separate Northwatch prison. The new cells that the mod author made were really well done, and helped to show off their eye for detail and level design. I wish we had seen more of this, and had the mod author flex on their ability to make new dungeons a bit more. While we had a new Northwatch prison to find information about Sigun, we also had a couple reused vanilla dungeons, including Erkenthand, which was used for part of Fort Black, and Morvoth's Lair, which was used as part of the Bloodlit Throne's secret hideaway. Reused dungeons aren't the end of the world, but it felt inconsistent with some of the other, more unique moments in the mod. The mod continues to place a lot of emphasis on reaching parts of the map that are normally inaccessible, leading to very long, sometimes tedious climbing sections. If anything, I feel like the mod doubled down on it in the reboot, adding a new section of this during the intro with Rose, as well as the new alternate route to Cyrodiil at the very end. For the trip to Cyrodiil's border, I would have preferred a short journey through a cave that leads to the border, similar to how you can make use of a smuggler's cave in Beyond Skyrim Bruma. I just feel like there are better ways to make your way to some of these quests, rather than having to mash the spacebar constantly to get to where you need to go. Ultimately, while I really enjoyed the reboot and the implications that it has for the reboot for Rigmor of Cyrodiil and the eventual release of Rigmor of Tamriel, I'm not sure if reboot would be the right term for this version of Rigmor of Bruma. While it's absolutely a major update to the mod, it feels more like a version 2, almost like how Legacy of the Dragonborn recently released its version 5 update. A lot of the mod has largely stayed the same, and while not every scene and quest needed an entire rewrite, many parts of it would have benefited from it in order to keep some of the storytelling much more consistent throughout. And aside from the story, there are still minor things that could have used tune-ups. This ranges from things like Quintus not matching his appearance in Rigmor of Cyrodiil, grammatical mistakes, and balancing for a lot of the fights. I know the balancing was updated a bit post-launch, but there are still some instances that are a bit abusive to the player. In the end, I think the reboot is a major step in the right direction, but could still use a little bit more polish in order to shine even brighter. And now, I just want to say thank you to Jim, who has always been incredibly hardworking as a mod author and someone who has been incredibly supportive of my work. I'm looking forward to seeing what comes next with Rigmor of Cyrodiil's re-release, as well as the sequel, Rigmor of Tamriel. Having just spoken to him a bit, I know there will be some changes in Cyrodiil to address the romance, marriage, and pregnancy plotlines, which some people, including myself, were not crazy about. Next week on Skyrim Saturday, we'll be picking up a brand new mod, but for the rest of this weekend, let's take a look at some of these vanilla quests. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you next time. In order to cover the vanilla quests, I made a new character and went through the base game start at Helgen, escaping with Hadvar and making my way towards Riverwood, at which point I met up with Rose and started the beginning for Rigmor of Bruma. After Rose's capture, I began using Rigmor as a follower for the first few main quests, so the footage you see will be showing off these new interactions and dialogue throughout.
Hey, Guardian, wait.
What is it? Are you okay?
What are you going to say to the Jarl?
We tell him about the dragon attack on Helgen, and then we'll be on our way. Okay?
Okay.
Don't wander off, stay near me, and let me do the talking.
Okay. After you.
Wow. That's impressive.
Hey! Watch out!
Hey, careful. There's someone up ahead. I wonder if they're friendly. Looks like some kind of puzzle. Hey, check this out. One of the symbol blocks has fallen. Could be a clue. Roger.
Guardian, what just happened?
I don't know.
Are you all right?
Yes, I think so.
Yeah, well, let's see if there's a way out nearby.
What's up? You okay?
So what now?
We take the claw to its owner.
Okay, I'll follow your lead.
The claw! The claw!
Look at that.
Guardian, what's happening?
I can't believe it. You're Dragonborn.
Dragonborn? What do you mean?
In the very oldest tales, back from when there were still dragons in Skyrim, the Dragonborn would slay dragons and steal their power. That's what you did, isn't it? Absorb the dragon's power.
I don't know what happened to me.
There's only one way to find out. Try to shout. That would prove it. According to the old legends, only the Dragonborn can shout without training, the way the dragons do.
Dragonborn? What are you talking about?
My grandfather used to tell stories about the Dragonborn. Those born with the dragon blood.
Foose!
Like old Tiber Septim himself.
I've never heard of Tiber Septim killing any dragons.
There weren't any dragons then, idiot. They're just coming back now for the first time in forever. But the old tales tell of the Dragonborn who could kill dragons and steal their power. You must be one.
What do you say, Irleth? You're being awfully quiet. Come on, Irleth. Tell us, do you believe in this Dragonborn business?
Some of you would be better off keeping quiet than flapping your gums on matters you don't know anything about. Here's a dead dragon, and that's something I definitely understand. Now we know we can kill them. But I don't need some mythical Dragonborn. Someone who can put down a dragon is more than enough for me.
You wouldn't understand, House Khan. You ain't an Ord.
I've been all across Tamriel. I've seen plenty of things just as outlandish as this. I'd advise you all to trust in the strength of your sword arm over tales and legends.
That was shouting, what you just did. Must be. You really are Dragonborn, then.
Rigmor, did you see that?
What the hell just happened? Are you okay?
I don't know.
You just sucked the soul right out of that dragon.
I can't explain it.
I knew something was up after what happened at the Word Wall in Bleak Falls Barrow. You're... Dragonborn.
Come on, let's go tell the Jarl what happened here.
Damn. That's just... wow. After you, I'll follow your lead.